Hello, royal folks. It's good to see you all here again. This is your regular dose of royal news and analysis. But before we start, please subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon. Thanks. So now, according to multiple reports, there was an earth-shattering blow-up fight between Harry and Meghan recently that reached cataclysmic levels. We're talking the kind of scorched earth royal rumble that would make the War of the Roses look like a backyard thumb wrestling match. From what the insiders are saying, this all went down after Harry got word about his pops King Charles and sister-in-law Kate's devastating cancer battles back in the UK. As you'd expect, the guy was jolted into trying to get back home ASAP to support his family through such a nightmare situation. But when he broke the news to Meghan that he needed to hotfoot it back to England, she completely lost her mind in a total meltdown. These sources claim there was screaming, crying, objects being thrown, the whole nine yards of unhinged dramatics. See, Meghan's always been pathologically terrified of Harry reuniting with his blood relatives and being pulled back into the gravity of the royal orbit without her. Her biggest fear is him regaining his senses and realizing what a soulless, status-chasing grifter she truly is once he's around his real family again. So when Harry dropped the bomb about needing to rush to his dad and sis-in-law's sides during their cancer fights, Meghan knew she was staring down the barrel of her worst nightmare coming true. She wasn't about to let her kick-punching bag aristocrat get anywhere near the royals without her strict control and monitoring. From the shocking footage that leaked, you can see Harry just saying screw this and storming out of their rented McMansion, while Meghan is still in full meltdown mode, screaming after him. He heads straight for the driveway, hops in a taxi, and just peels out, leaving her crazy ass behind. For all her bluster about wanting privacy from the media vultures, it's truly wild that Meghan let herself get caught on CCTV coming completely unglued like that. She was in such a blind rage over the possibility of Harry escaping her talons that she didn't even care about keeping up appearances anymore. Can you just imagine the unmitigated fury that woman must have felt, watching the one final golden ticket she had to relevancy and fortune just hop in a cab and try to jet off without her? The indignity of it all for a status obsessive like her must have been unbelievable. Of course, we all know Harry didn't actually make it to the airport or back to England at that point. He just needed to get away from Meghan's latest triggered temper tantrum for some breathing space. But still, the fact he was so fed up that he resorted to that speaks volumes about where their grotesque media marriage really stands. For me though, I'm just dying to know exactly what insane rantings and accusations Meghan was hurling at Harry while he made his attempt at an escape. Was she screeching about him betraying her by going to visit his cancer-stricken loved ones without her cold-hearted supervision? Threatening to cut off his allowance from Netflix and Spotify if he dared spend time with the royals? Or maybe she let some real truth bombs slip about how she always viewed him as her aimless puppet-willing to cause familial chaos, all in hopes of clinging to her coattails of Z-list celeb relevancy. There's just so many potential unhinged diatribes she could have unleashed in the heat of that moment. One thing's for sure though, Harry's current living situation is about as miserable and volatile as it gets. Just watching him literally trying to run away from his own wife and mother of his kids shows you how horrifically toxic and trapped he's become in the twisted Frankenstein's monster of his own making. At the end of the day, this is what happens when you let an opportunistic grifter fully sink her claws into you. Meghan has taken full control of Harry's life through a combination of manipulation, intimidation, and literally separating him from every other supportive relationship he had. The guy has been so beaten down by her at this point that he couldn't even muster up the willpower to get on a plane and visit his own father and sister-in-law as they're fighting for their lives against freaking cancer. For any semi-decent human being, that should be an automatic no-brainer, family obligation-wise. But Meghan has hollowed out what little remained of Harry's self-worth and sense of autonomy to that terrifying degree. So while part of me feels pity for the hapless fool he's become, Harry also made this bed for himself. If he had any shred of self-awareness or backbone left, he would have fought like hell to actually get on that plane, cancer battles be damned, not meekly succumb to Meghan's abusive tantrums and control like her aimless puppet. But maybe I'm being too harsh here. What's your take on seeing Harry's desperate escape attempt from the chains of his own disastrous marriage, only to come up short? Do you think he'll eventually muster the courage and will to break free from Meghan's toxic clutches and make it back to the UK? Or is he a permanently broken man at this point? More importantly, what outrageous accusations do you think Meghan was lobbing at poor Harry during her meltdown here? I need to know your wildest guesses in the comments. If you got a suitably unhinged theory, you might just take home the grand prize of a year's supply of anti-jealousy cream, Meghan's most frequently used beauty product. So go off, fam, and let's break down and analyze this insane domestic dispute that was somehow caught on the world's watchful cameras. And if you're just as appalled by the twisted state of Meghan and Harry's imploded marriage as I am, do me a solid and blast that angry button into oblivion. Let's bring the full fury of the internet down on these two. Stay tuned for more updates on the intriguing world of royalty. Until then, thanks for watching. We'll see you again with some more fascinating news about the royal family. Thank you.